I am joined now by New York Times best-selling author, Roger Stone. He wrote Clinton's War Against Women. He was a former Trump advisor and strategist, and he's been around the game of politics a long time. We are happy to have him on New Jersey 101.5. Roger, good morning.
Bill, I am delighted to be with you.
So, thanks for taking the time with us, Roger. It's amazing. I saw this poll this morning, and this came out about an hour ago, that CNN has Trump at the top. So maybe you can help me put some context on this. What is causing this Trump surge, despite all the efforts of so many people to call him a liar and say he's going to flame out? What do you think is happening?
You know, it's a phenomenon that I call Trump-nado. Voters, they're sick of career politicians. They're sick of being told every 4 years, oh, I have a 6-point plan or a 10-point plan, or, we're going to close Guantanamo, or we're going to withdraw our troops. Now we're sending.
Or 1,000 points of light. Remember that?
Right. So voters now got to the point where they think that all politicians are full of it. And then Donald Trump appears on the scene, and he's a truth teller. He's blunt. He's direct. Sometimes he's euphemistic, but when it comes to the big picture, for example, ISIS and the fact that it needs to be crushed, enough with the pinprick bombing attacks that are achieving nothing. You need an all-out effort here to crush them that is not politically correct and won't get deterred. And people think that Trump is a guy who means what he says and says what he means.
So do you attribute that? I mean, you said truth teller, and I think you're right. I think that's how people are reacting. But how does he reconcile this claim of thousands on the rooftops in Jersey City with the label of truth teller when, you know, it seems to me that people are almost overlooking the number, that they don't care?
Yeah, I don't think they care, because the bottom line of it is there either is or there is not a stream of radical Muslim already in the country, already embedded in the fabric of our society, that was exultant over the attacks on America on 9/11. And the answer is there is. Whether it's dozens or hundreds or thousands is almost at this point immaterial. Contrast that with the President of the United States. You can't get the words out of his mouth.
It's shocking to me, Roger. Are you surprised at this? I mean, I can't see. I was at the gym early this morning, and, you know, I flip through. I see CNN. I see MSNBC. And everyone is still they're having this pain almost when they try to express the motives behind the attack in San Bernardino. And they're stretching to keep saying, well, you know, mixed motives. We're not really sure. Are they really not sure? It's absurd, I think.
I think anybody with any common sense is sure. Yeah. But for some reason, the administration doesn't seem to want to tilt, nor does the media. Look, let's remember where this all started. This all started only weeks ago when Donald Trump said, hold on a second. George W. Bush did not keep us safe on 9/11. And, of course, everybody jumped on him. How could you say that? That's outrageous. In fact, Trump is again proven right. The Clinton administration and the Bush administration had numerous warnings about the attack on 9/11. George Tenet, the CIA director, not only said it in front of Congress, he says it in this new HBO series, Spy Masters. We had numerous reports of men being trained to fly planes into buildings. You know what we did, Bill? We did nothing.
Right.
Nothing whatsoever. We deported the sources. A guy walked into the Atlantic City, New Jersey police station and told them the whole plot, exactly what would go down. We deported that guy. By the way, that's in Tom Kaine's 9/11 commission.
That's in the report. That's in the 9/11 commission, that story.
Yep.
Yeah, it's incredible. Yep. Is that in your book, your new book?
It is in my upcoming book on Jeb and the Bush crime.
I was going to say the Bush crime. I just saw that on Amazon this morning. That's a pretty radical statement, but I know you're going to stand by it. Just give me the highlights a little bit about why you wrote that book and why you think it's relevant.
Sure, it's pretty easy. Prescott Bush, the patriarch, he makes the family money arming the Nazis, lending money to Adolf Hitler, also owning a steel mill that makes money on slave labor outside of Auschwitz. George H.W. Bush, as Vice President of the United States, he oversees a covert operation to run millions of dollars worth of cocaine into the United States to sell it, to illegally raise money for the Nicaraguan rebels. I also detail what really happened around the Reagan assassination, which was an attempted coup d'etat, which, thank God, failed because Reagan, as you know, survived. I talk about the illegal war that George W. Bush brought us into, because there was there were no weapons of mass destruction. And then the shady and criminal business dealings of Jeb, who was an active drug dealer in Houston, in Miami, in college, in boarding school, and I document it. Now, Bill, when you write a book like this, believe me.
A little bit of controversy you're stirring up?
The lawyers for your publisher put you through the ringer like nothing you have ever seen. You have to justify every word, every comma, every sentence. You got to document it. Sometimes you got to go back and get more documentation. After a four-month epic battle with the lawyers for my publisher, not a word came out of this manuscript. So I'm looking forward to its publication.
Yeah, I mean, it sounds like it's all the makings for an Oliver Stone film. Is what it sounds like.
From your mouth to God's ear.
Exactly. Roger, let me ask you, if you can hang in with me, I've got to take a quick break for traffic and weather, but I want to come back and talk a little bit about this feud between Christie and Donald Trump. So if you just hang on the line, I appreciate it. Thank you, Roger. Okay, that's New York Times bestselling author Roger Stone.